Hi, I'm Megan Gardner.
I'm Jeff Weigman.
And we are the owners of Guard Up, and we run the Wizards and Warriors camp, as well as the Nerf Zombie camp here in Westford and over the Burlington location. We are here today for a successful counselor and training program. It's also part of our leadership program. And we were doing a bunch of really cool things with the kids and teens and getting them involved in the process of becoming leaders in our programs. So what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about the programs with you and have you understand what a really cool place this is and why you want to be a part of it.
So this is a training session that we have annually, and the target is the Monster Campers, counselors in training. We call them Monster Campers at our camp, and we invite them here for a 6-hour training session. And what we do is we talk about all the things that are important to help them be better counselors. So we talk about aspects of safety, we talk about measuring and monitoring behaviors and characteristics of our kids. We also talk about just general safety principles around weapon safety and how to look at our environment in a very safe format. They come here and we immediately put them into a series of sessions and activities, very well structured such that there's not a lot of class time, so to speak. They're up and they're around and they're getting engaged. They learn sword play in a very safe way. And this is done through a series of exercises so they have a practical understanding of what we're trying to get across to them.
We really focus on trying to make this as interactive as possible. And we keep all of our information in short 15-minute chunks. And we jump around and go back to the subject. And that's what helps with the retention of the lesson. Repetition, as we know, is very important in the lesson plan. But to make that repetition something that's interesting and to keep those bits of information in shorter chunks of time that are easy to retain. We do our mentorship programs before the camp season, but the leadership programs, which are part of the CITs often go to the leadership programs, and the leadership team can also come to the CIT programs. They can occur for the span of a day or even an entire weekend, usually in the fall and in the spring, because that's when the weather cooperates with us. We even have like mini workshops or even our weekly program over at our Guard Up Center in Burlington. That's the leadership training course, and that's held every week, and it's an hour and a half class. And it focuses on classroom management skills and teaching and communication. A lot of really important life skills as well as leadership skills that translate not just to what we do here, but also to anything that the student does in later on in life or when they hold their first job. For example, one of the things we covered just a few weeks ago was how to participate in an interview successfully, so a job interview, how to write a resume and present the resume, writing a cover letter. So we really like to cover the full gamut of life skills involved for any teenager essentially to become an adult. I think the main reason why we do these programs, we're both parents, and we kind of collude and come together and figure out what are the qualities that we really look for in our kids and in our future staff and in anything that we expect of an adult to be able to operate in our environment and to be able to communicate effectively with children and also with adults. So we do this in a very creative environment where there's a lot of interactivity and dynamic situations. We try to keep the energy up, and instead of a lecture format, it's more dynamic than that. So we provide a lot of play because, believe it or not, when you're involved in creative play, you are ripe for learning, and that's been scientifically proven. So there's the creative play element of it. Another part of it is the personal growth. It's just looking at providing these kids with the opportunity to gain self-confidence and creative problem solving and other important attributes.
We go back to it now and again. We talk about it, we put it into a practical, so they have an experience actually teaching the class. And in many cases, these students of ours are teaching that class, something that they're very, very knowledgeable in. It could be wielding a sword, it could be making an omelet, as an example. They become the authority and they become the instructor for the rest of the class. and then we take it, and then we highlight their attributes they have and their various delivery styles and how they communicate and how they use inflection, for example. And then we come back the next week and we touch on it again. And we see just significant progress and of each of our students as they go through this course.
I think the key thing here is that we're looking to create an environment that fosters a well-rounded individual. And ultimately, we want to have kids, teens, and adults who look at education as a lifelong passion, something that they want to constantly endeavor towards. Participants can expect that when they show up, they're going to be first introduced to each other, and then through some games. And then they're going to get right into the lesson plan. And like I said, we try to keep it very dynamic and interactive. Get them on their feet, down on the ground, up and up again, swords in their hands, sometimes pencil and paper in their hands. It's just constantly paced to keep the motion going and to keep them interested and actively learning.
Exactly. I think that also we change the environments themselves. So, for example, the workshop today is here at East Boston Camps, where the camp is being held at this year. We also have the facility as well. So we change the environments around. We go inside, we go outside. We take advantage of everything we can have to really create an environment for learning. This is a very critical time in their life. So every progression in every child is different, but there's the in search of, and there's a lot of questions we believe that are being asked internally for kids in the teens. And we're here to provide not answers per se, but at least the right way to ask questions and the best way to get the answers within themselves.
What teens can expect and what their parents really appreciate is that one of the key lessons is for the teens to learn how to step out of their own shoes and put themselves into the shoes of the person they're trying to work with. That might be a student, that might be a camper, it might be their parent. And it's about getting them to connect with that person and try to empathize with them and try to communicate clearly and understand what that person's communicating with them. It's a very big part of our training.
This is, I think, an incredible process and product that we have here where we can offer to teenagers a way to find out more about themselves and a way to promote learning as a lifelong tool.
I think that I think the best thing about this isn't just what we're teaching them, but the how, which is that creative process. And we really do put a lot of time and energy into the best possible way of reaching our students and having them retain as much as possible on the way out. So so we may not cover a breadth of like 10 subjects in an 8-hour day, because we really want them to retain 3 or 4 of those subjects really well, as opposed to walking out of here with 10 subjects, which they can recount 3 or 4 of them. So we don't want to overwhelm them. We just really want them to come out like, okay, I've got that. I got these 3 things, and I got them really well, and I've had a chance to practice them. And I've had a chance to practice them in a really fun and creative environment where I got to express myself and really play around with these ideas and have a chance to practice these ideas in a live environment. And that's really how you learn. You don't learn by listening or by watching. You learn by doing, and that's what we try to do with most of our students.